Hi, everyone. I'm Kevin Scott, Chief Technology Officer at Microsoft. I'm also an engineer, a maker, and most importantly, a lifelong learner. At Microsoft, I'm super lucky to be able to learn directly from some of the brightest and most creative minds in the world. In this series, you'll get that same opportunity to hear from the folks at the front lines advancing the future of technology. They'll talk about work that's not just critical to our company's strategy, but things that I find genuinely fascinating and inspiring. I hope that you'll feel the same way. So stick around and let's learn a little bit together.
My name is Bonnie Kruft. I am the Deputy Director of AI for Science over in the Cambridge Lab in the UK. AI for Science is a team within Microsoft Research. So we're working across the natural sciences, applying the use of AI to really impact things like drug discovery, materials discovery, and also things like climate and weather prediction. One of the exciting components of AI for Science is actually seeing how our models are making impact in the real world. So already today, we have partners externally in pharmaceuticals or in materials discovery, where we're actually taking the models that we're building and using that for, say, molecular design. We actually did that with GIDI, the Global Health Drug Discovery Institute, and we were able to find a molecule for tuberculosis that's actually over 100 times more effective in terms of binding than the leading compound. If you imagine the drug discovery process is, imagine it's like a filter or like screening. So you have hundreds upon thousands of known compounds, and you can take those known compounds and you can augment them in some way. And the idea is you want to find a compound or molecule that's going to bind to your target as efficiently as possible. So in biology, in disease biology, your genes code a protein and the disease is associated either with something in your body or a bacteria that's producing something within your body. And so the target is we want to find that core piece of biology that by either revving it up or shutting it down can make some impact on the disease. And that's what you're looking for when you find the molecule, which effectively becomes the drug, to bind to that protein and then make that impact, make some sort of effect on the disease biology. If you think, you know, a 10,000 foot level, it's really about screening. And so in traditional drug discovery, we know all these known compounds, we can make these adjustments to it. Let's try to tune that as much as possible and filter through as many compounds as possible, test them out in lab, see how they bind to it, see what impact it has on it. And then eventually at the end, we'll come out with maybe a few candidates that we take across to the next stage of the pipeline. By using tools like TamGen or some of the other generative AI tools that we're building, we can squish down that entire pipeline into a shorter amount of time and be more efficient in actually making more positive decisions with a higher probability of success. So hugely promising results, not yet to the point where it's a medicine that's being used in people, because there's a rigorous process around safety that it still would need to go through, but it's very promising results indeed. Every molecule material that we discover through AI needs to go through rigorous safety testing. So in the example of drug discovery, there are rigorous testing procedures in place for medicines that are eventually made to market today. We need to make sure that what we discover through AI also goes through a very rigorous safety testing process. The same should be true for materials. Materials that we introduce to society, we also need to make sure that there's not some unforeseen impact that it has on humanity. We can find materials that help to capture carbon that ensures that we have, for generations to come, a better environment for all our families to live in and grow up in. My work is incredibly fun. I look forward to coming to work every day and working with scientists with deep domain expertise in their field, or with machine learning researchers that are looking at, you know, how to approach these problems in different ways, or the engineers that are looking at how to actually scale things and make it usable and reusable by not only us, but by our customers. I am most excited about the potential to find something through these AI models that we're building that really changes the lives of people around us.